Good morning students, welcome back to the English Channel Prime. Students, in the last class we have completed the pre-reading task, the explanation, all the hard words and meaning, and also we have enacted this play, The Great Sacrifice. We did the skit and you all played your characters very well. So I think all of you understood this chapter very well. Now in this session let's do the question answers, comprehension question answers, all the grammars like the present perfect tense, simple past tense, the use of verbs and paragraph writing. So let's start with the comprehension. Open page number 57. Answer the following in 2 to 3 sentences each. Question number 1. Why were Padma and Panna worried? Answer. Padma and Panna were worried because everything was going wrong since the death of Ranaji. No one in the state of Mewar was happy. Children, in this I am giving you all the answers, but you can write your own answer, you can frame your own sentences, but you should not skip any keyword. The grammatical things should be correct and you can make your own sentences. Now question number 2. A. Name the person who was ambitious. Yes, answer is Banbir, a half brother of Prince Uday Singh, was ambitious. Question B. What is he compared to? Yes, he is compared to a snake. C. Why were the other nobles powerless against him? Answer. The nobles had become mean and selfish. They were quarreling among themselves. Though they hated Banbir, they were not strong enough to go against him. Question number 3. A. What did Banbir make up his mind to do? Answer. He resolved to kill Prince Uday Singh. Question B. Why had he resolved to do this? Answer. He wanted to do this to become the permanent Rana of Mewar. Question number 4. A. What did the prince's mother tell Panna when she was dying? Answer. The prince's mother told Panna that she had lost everything except her son. She was leaving him in her responsibility, in her charge, and she asked Panna to bring him up like her own child and protect him from all harm. Question B. What did Panna promise the Rani? Panna promised the queen that she would give her life to save the life of the prince. Question number 5. A. What news did Champa bring? Answer. Champa said that Banbir was talking to a man outside and he would be there in a few minutes to kill Prince Uday Singh. Question B. What did Banbir have in his hand? Banbir had a naked sword in his hand. Question number 6. A. Why did Panna change the prince's clothes? Panna wanted to dress her own son in the prince's clothes because she wanted to save the prince and her child should look like a prince and Prince Uday Singh should look like an ordinary child. Question B. Where did she put him? Answer. She put him in a basket. Question C. What did she cover him with? Answer. She covered him with flowers and leaves. Question number 7. Whose clothes did Panna make her baby wear? Whose bed did she put him in? Answer. Panna made her baby wear the prince's clothes and she put him in the ivory bed of the prince. Question number 8. Who did Banbir kill? Did he realize his mistake? Answer. Banbir killed Panna's son, Chandan, thinking that he was the prince. No, he did not realize his mistake. Question number 9. What are the main qualities you appreciate in Panna? Give reasons in support of your answer. Answer. Panna was a brave and courageous woman. In the time of danger, she did not lose heart. She decided quickly what she should do to save the prince's life. She did not hesitate to sacrifice the life of her own son. She showed utmost courage and presence of mind. She was ready to do anything to keep her promise. So her resolute mind and loyalty deserve our appreciation. Done, children? Now let's go to the grammar part, second main. So here, children, in this chapter, the grammar is present perfect tense. Children, present perfect tense meaning the combination of both present tense and the perfect aspect. That is, the past event that has some present consequences. Like, it says about anything that happened in the past but continued in the present or had some result in the present situation. For example, if I say mother has already prepared the lunch, that means the action is already finished, but the result is we are talking about it now. I have lost my bag, that means it is already lost and we are talking about it now. Like Risha has missed her flight. Same again, the action is already done and we are saying about the consequences now. That is called present perfect tense. That means it refers to any action or state that either occurred at an indefinite time in the past or began in the past and continued to the present time. For example, if I'll say we have talked before. So here the time is not definite when we talk, but it is already done. So that is called present perfect tense. Or he has grown tall over a period of time. So here also the work is already done. The action is already done and we are talking about it now. So here that is called present perfect tense. And in this present perfect tense, you have to use the tense is formed by using auxiliary verb has or have plus the past participle. Past participle meaning adding ed to the base form of the verb. Like we can say that the plane has taken off. So here it is has taken off is the present perfect tense. Mother has already prepared. So has plus prepare will become prepared. Ed to the base form, past participle. Done. And simple past tense meaning which the work or the action which is already completed, which is already finished. Done, children. So here we have to, in the present perfect tense, you have to use has or have plus the past participle of the base verb. Now let's do the third question. Use the following present time expressions in meaningful situations like still, ate, now, just. So let's do. So children, here these time expressions should be used before, after the auxiliary verb and before the main verb. So he had just made tea. He has still not completed his work. He hasn't come yet. He has just gone out. Or she has cooked some food now. Okay. So and the simple past tense is used with the past time expressions like yesterday, last month, last year, last week, etc. Like I took my sick neighbor to the hospital yesterday. I took my mother to the hospital last week, etc. Done. Now let's go to the third main. Rewrite these sentences using the words given in brackets at the appropriate places. As I said, it should be used after the auxiliary verb and before the base verb. So the children have returned from the zoo. Just. You should use the children have just returned from the zoo. Present perfect tense. Second, B. I have had a ride on a camel. Never. I have never had a ride on a camel. C. We have had our lunch already. So here it is had is used. Past perfect tense. We have had our lunch. Sorry, present perfect tense. We have had our lunch already. D. Lata has sung before foreign audiences often. Lata has often sung before foreign audiences. E. I have seen the Republic Day Parade only once in my life. I have seen the Republic Day Parade only once in my life. Done, children. Now let's go to the fourth main. Use the present perfect tense of the verbs given in brackets and fill in the blanks to complete the sentences. As I said, for the present perfect tense, we have to use has or have plus the past participle form of the main or base verb. So Mrs. Sharma dash you dash draw money from the bank. So what will come? Yes. Have you drawn money from the bank? Mr. Sharma. Yes, I have. Mrs. Sharma. Where dash you dash it? Where have you put it? Then next page, Mr. Sharma taking off his bush shirt and throwing it on the bed. I have put it in my briefcase. Wife opening the briefcase. No, you haven't. It is not here. Husband getting worried. I put it in this pocket of the briefcase. Dash someone dash it. So have someone stolen it? Wife, I hope you have not dropped it. Husband getting angry. No, I am not careless. You might be careless. I very carefully counted the notes and put them in this pocket. What shall we do? Rupees 500 is a big amount. Wife picking up his bush shirt and folding it. Don't worry. She smiles. Husband, we have lost 500 rupees and you are smiling. Wife, we have not lost the money. Husband, have you taken it out of my briefcase? Wife, no, I haven't. It was never in your briefcase. Husband, where is the money? Wife, it is here. It is in the pocket of your bush shirt. Now tell me who is careless. Husband, heaving a sigh of relief. Pardon me, my dear. I have been careless. Wife, smiling. Come, let's have some tea. So here you have to use the has or have auxiliary verb plus the third form of the verb or the base or root verb. Done, children? Now let's do the second. Now mark the piece of conversation with appropriate stress and intonation. We did it already. Now let's do the fifth main. Match the words in column A with their antonyms in column B. A, strong, weak, like, dislike, end, begin, outside, inside. B, fill in the blanks with the words from the first column and add sentences using words from column B as well. Don't go, dash, it is raining. Don't go outside, it is raining. Stay inside. The hero dies at the dash of the film, at the end of the film. Now let's begin our work. All of us dash ice cream. All of us like ice cream. Arun dislikes it. The chair is dash, you cannot break it. The chair is strong, you cannot break it. You are weak. Now C, fill in the blanks using the correct tense forms of the verbs given in the brackets. The farmers and their families dash in their fields since 6 o'clock. Have been in their fields since 6 o'clock in the morning. The farmers dash have plowed their fields and their wives dash have sowed the seeds. Their daughters have put earth on the seeds and their sons dash have watered the fields. Done, children? Now D, rewrite the above passages in the singular form. Begin in this way. A farmer and his family dash, yes, you can write, has been in their fields since 6 o'clock in the morning. You can continue like this. The farmer has plowed his field and his wife has sowed the seeds. His daughter has put earth or soil on the seeds and his son has watered the field. Using the present perfect tense has plus the third form of the verb, we have completed this passage. Now E, imagine that the above scene took place yesterday. Rewrite the passage making minor alterations where necessary. So you can write, at 6 o'clock in the morning, the farmers were plowing their fields. The farmers plowed their fields and their wives sowed their seeds. Their daughters got earth or mud on the seeds and their sons watered the fields. Done, children? Now let's go to the sixth main. Based on the sentence, we have to change the verb. My wife dashed to get a job, but she has not succeeded yet. My wife has been trying to get a job. The patient has had biscuits and has also dashed a glass of milk. Yes, drunk a glass of milk. The bridegroom has dashed not to take a single paisa as dowry decided. D. The farmers had dashed that the safe of corn would fall known. The village panchayat has dashed. My father as a member of the panchayat, yes, nominated. Now, last one. Seventh man, imagine that Panna has just come out of the bedchamber and is talking to you. Complete this paragraph. Let's complete. Panna, I dash Uday Singh's life. I have saved Uday Singh's life. I dash him in a basket. I have hidden him in a basket. Next, Padma and Champa dash the basket out. Have taken the basket out. Bunby dash my innocent little boy, but I am not heartbroken. Had killed my innocent little boy. I dash my duty. I have done my duty. I dash my promise to the late queen. I have kept my promise to the late queen. So here we learned the use of present perfect tense, that is any action that has happened in the past but having some present consequences. Done, children? Hope you understand everything. If any doubt, ask in the comment box.